the election. One attendee, the Times says, even pitched a multi-million-dollar proposal for a social media manipulation to help elect Donald Trump. Joining me tonight, one of the reporters who shares the byline and the report, New York Times international correspondent David Kirkpatrick. David, can you just explain what the purpose of this meeting was, which took place 3 months before the election?
Well, the purpose was clearly to offer help to the Trump campaign to elect Donald Trump. The main organizer of the meeting was Eric Prince, who at the beginning of the meeting appears to have said, you know, my friends and I are doing everything we can to get your father elected. He said that to Donald Trump Jr. And the most important person in the meeting appears to have been George Nader, who was there as an emissary from the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi in the UAE, and according to Mr. Nader, also from the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia. And he said very explicitly that they wanted to see a Donald Trump elected and that they would do everything they could to help in that effort.
And Donald Trump Jr., was he receptive to this outreach?
Well, he doesn't appear to have been too overtly negative, according to people who were present for the conversation. He put out a statement at our request when we contacted him and said that he had not been receptive and the proposal hadn't gone anywhere. But what's interesting is this is the beginning of a long relationship for George Nader and the Trump campaign. What happens next after that meeting is that George Nader suddenly becomes a part of many meetings with senior figures in the Trump campaign, including Jared Kushner, Steve Bannon, Michael Flynn. And these meetings go on even after Trump is in the White House. And then if we fast forward again, you see his patron, the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi, Mohammed bin Zayed, sneaking into the United States in December for an undisclosed meeting with the Trump campaign during the transition, not telling the Obama administration and irking them considerably. And then, even more mysterious, you see the same guy, George Nader, turn up again with Eric Prince in the Seychelles at Mohammed bin Zayed's second home or vacation home there for a meeting that is designed to put together Eric Prince as a representative of the Trump campaign with a Russian businessman close to Vladimir Putin and also close to George Nader. So whatever happened in that meeting on August 3rd with Donald Trump Jr., it was the beginning of something. We don't know exactly what, but something started that day.
And why exactly did Saudi Arabia and the Emirates want to help get Trump elected? Is that clear?
Well, they didn't like President Obama's foreign policy in the Middle East. They didn't like the Iran deal. They didn't like his hands-off approach to Syria. They didn't like his approach to the Arab Spring. And to a large extent, they thought that President Hillary Clinton would be an extension of those policies. They didn't much like the things she was doing and saying when she was Obama's Secretary of State. And they thought that Trump would be a stronger hand, so to speak.
It's important to know that the outreach through this emissary, continued after the election.
Yeah, that is important. That is important. And I think that's one reason why the special prosecutor, Robert Mueller, has taken a keen interest in George Nader, who's now cooperating with that investigation.
Just to be clear, it is illegal for foreign governments or individuals to be involved in American elections.
Yes, it is. That's right. It's now, George Nader is an American citizen, but he was clearly there on behalf of Mohammed bin Zayed, the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. He made that evident in the meeting. He was showing off pictures of himself with the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia to try to convey his bona fides that he really was their representative. And the other gentleman he brought with him an Israeli technology specialist who was laying out the possibility of doing a kind of online social media campaign with some fake avatar and Facebook pages for the Trump campaign. He was not an American citizen. He was an Israeli, and that would also be illegal if that help were either given or accepted by the Trump campaign. Now, we don't know what happened, but as I say, it was the beginning of a long relationship.
That's fascinating. David Kirkpatrick, appreciate it. Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Well, coming up, the president demands an investigation into the people investigating him. What the Justice Department is doing about it.